Hi, this is a DC-to-DC converter from Bangwoods. Now, I had another identical piece, which you might have already seen in many of my previous videos. Even though its power is 300 watts, but the output voltage is only 12 volts, 25 amperes. So this DC-to-DC converter cannot be used to charge your batteries. I requested them to make a buck boost converter with an output of 13.8 volts DC. And here you can see that the input voltage range is 9 volts to 36 volts now. Applications. Let's say that you have an old printer adapter and you want to charge your 12 volts battery with it, the voltage of which should be at least 13.8 volts DC. But the printer power supply output is as high as 32 volts DC. So for that, we are going to need this 13.8 volts DC converter. Red and black wires are positive and negative for the input, while yellow and black wires are positive and negative for the output. So here, as you can see, the setup printer power supply is feeding this DC to DC converter. The outputs are still not connected. Battery voltage, as you can see, is 11.5 volts DC. So let's first measure the output from the DC converter. And here we have 13.94 volts. As you can see, 13.94 volts, which is very good, better than I expected. Now I'm going to connect the converter to the battery. Now if the voltage increases, then it means the battery has started charging. And here, as you can see, that the voltage has started increasing at a really high speed. Let's leave it like that for some time. In the meantime, let's also check the current being fed to my battery. So it is around 1 ampere. Yeah, 0.8. Now let's check the voltage that this battery has gained. Okay, removing one terminal, and here it has gained 13 volts and falling rapidly because I didn't give it much time to charge. Application 2. Let's say that we have a laptop charger lying around at home and we want to charge our huge 12 volts 150 ampere hour truck battery or inverter battery. Although if we measure the voltage, it is not fully charged, so it needs charging. So here, as you can see, that my inverter battery is still working. Now the voltage of a laptop charger ranges from 15 volts to 20 volts. But the voltage of a truck battery is around 14 volts DC. So again, what we are going to do is use the 13.8 volts converter in between the laptop charger and the battery. And it is going to fix the output to 13.8 volts and charge our battery safely. Now here, as you can see, that's the power cord and the laptop charger is connected to the power cord, and the output from the laptop charger is connected to the DC converter. And here the multimeter is measuring the voltage of the battery right now, and I have taken out two extra wires here which will be connected to the DC converter. As you can see, that the meter is showing increase and change in voltage, which means that the battery has started charging. So now it's quite clear that the battery has gained charge and it is still charging. So let's do the current measurement. As you can see, that the drawn current is around 1.8 amperes and it will decrease as the battery starts gaining charge. Yeah, it shoots to 2 amperes sometimes. So similarly, you can use any other power supply ranging from 9 volts to 36 volts and convert it to fixed 13.8 volts DC. Now let's say that you have a solar panel and you want to charge your 12 volts battery with it, but unfortunately the solar panel voltage is more than 21 volts DC. So again, we can use the DC converter. Now comes the next application, which is using it as a simple DC power supply 12 volts. See, it works really good for powering up your bulbs or DC motors. Now, the fifth application is using this DC converter for electric generators. Now, this is a three-phase brushless generator with an AC output. So, we are going to need a three-phase bridge rectifier for it to convert the output to DC. Next, the output of the rectifier will be connected to the input of the DC converter. So this way we can get fixed 13.8 volts output from a variable DC output of a wind turbine or any generator.